In the platform of Law and People, we have been discussing lots of issues pertaining to law, constitutional rights, which affects the nation as a whole, and more importantly, the common man. We thought it is high time that we bring on board the law enforcers, the persons from the police fraternity, in the platform to get their side of the view pertaining to these aspects. We were very fortunate as DGP of Assam, Sri Kuladhar Saikia, consented to be part of the show. And in spite of his busy schedule, we met him at his official residence. Viewers might be aware that Kuladhar Saikia is also a well-known literator. As we wait for him, I go to the books written by him. Welcome viewers, we are in for a special edition of Law and People. Today we have brought a personality who is well known in our part of the world as a person dedicated to the cause of law and order. Sri Kuladhar Saikia, the DGP of Assam. He is not only the DGP, but he is also a known literator. A Sahitya Academy Award winner, Sri Kuladhar Saikia, sir, with us. Welcome, sir, to DD Northeast, and first of all, thank you for sparing your time out of a busy schedule.
Thank you very much, yeah.
Sir, you are known as a person who is basically a literator first and then a super cop. My first question would be that how does it feel like, you know, to be a super cop at the same time a literator also?
Look, these two are not, mutually exclusive. You can be a writer, you can have any profession. So I'm taking it that way because my profession is different from what is my hobby. Writing is my hobby, so I'm into it for a long time since my school days. And I'm continuing with it also whenever I get off time.
So it's been a passion for you basically?
That's true, yeah. I enjoy writing, I enjoy reading too. So I feel it's good to be in such type of hobbies and such type of job.
Right, sir. Now, I'd like to shift the pattern a little bit and come to your main job, which is basically policing. And if you look at policing in a democratic country, it is basically about enforcing law, preventing crimes, responding to emergencies, and being also a support service kind of an organization. With so much of variety into this kind of job, how do you police officers, especially the top ones, adjust and keep yourself in tune with so many things happening around?
See, it's definitely a very challenging job because in a democratic society, there are a lot of aspirations.
Absolutely.
Which do come up off and on. And in a place like in Assam, where you have multitude of communities,
right,
ethnic groups,
right,
and a growing middle-class citizen,
right.
So you have too many factors coming
right.
together.
Right.
Apart from the law, traditional
right.
crime situations,
absolutely, sir.
You have different sorts of parameters.
You're right.
You know, you have to cater to the needs of the people of different communities.
Absolutely.
Then you know, and how to tackle the law and order which arise out of their aspirations.
Aspirations.
So all these sort of things are there, plus new forms of crimes are coming to the society. You have to tune yourself, you have to go for capacity building.
Right.
You have to think, you know, that, you know, criminals may be a little bit more advanced.
Yes, sir. I'd like to just say one thing, what you were saying, add up to what you were saying, basically. The domain of crime has become larger.
Yes,
and
yes.
There are cyber crimes. There are crimes which have not been thought earlier, even crimes related to older people, aged people, and of course, you know,
even
the
children.
Economic crimes, sir,
yes,
economic
yes.
offenses.
You raised a very important point because the domains of crime have increased tremendously because it's expected also because along with the development of different technologies and the knowledge base of people, the nature of crime also changes.
Okay.
And you have seen now how newly, you know, the cybercrime has come, then social media is
it's
also
a challenge,
working in such some time, you know. So all sorts of things have come. In fact, as you say, the economic offenses, it has gone in a different ways, through internet, through mobile connectivity, all sorts of cyber crimes are happening.
Absolutely.
So, and economic offenses are also interlinked with that. My point is, basically, you have to look at crime from different perspectives, in the sense that how the society is preparing to cope up with it. You have the law and order parameters, the policing aspect, the enforcement aspect, along with that, the societal role also, where police authorities are engaging the people to take care of the different sorts of crime, like, you know, we have done some counseling with the young people so that, you know, how to tackle with social media, fake news and things like that. And then, in fact, we have had a lot of awareness campaigns with the teachers, students, how to tackle such type of crimes. So these sort of community interventions are very important.
Absolutely. So as you say, that you know, a proper ecosystem, you know, is necessary to tackle this kind of issue.
Yes, yes.
And one thing that comes to my mind at this point, sir, Assam being a state which is basically the gateway of Northeast, and it shares its boundaries with so many states along with international borders also, and there are rugged terrains, forests, you know, does that make, you know, your duties more difficult, sir, the terrain problem?
There are opportunities and also certain weaknesses in such system, because see, we have beautiful greenery in the Northeast. The problem with this is, you know, you have a little bit of communication system which has not been properly developed, right?
Infrastructure.
Infrastructure, then road communications. In fact, there are a lot of areas where it's very it's you know, areas where you cannot get the mobile connectivity because it's been shaded area. You know, so all sorts of challenges are there. But more or less, you see, in such states where you have some people who are belong to different communities. So it's a really good challenge. It's a, should take it as a sort of an opportunity to work in such places.
Right, sir. And when we have people like you, you know, in command of the force, we are always hopeful. Now, sir, but one thing which is a national phenomena also, like crime against women, is on the rise. It's a shameful thing. Our heads hang in shame. So what have you done? Anything more to the existing things to tackle these kind of issues, sir, which is, you know, sir, very shameful.
This increase in crime against women should be looked at in two different perspectives, you know.
Right,
first one is, you know, earlier people you not used to come to the police stations out of fear, apprehension, social stigma.
Absolutely.
Now the people have started coming in with their complaints.
Absolutely.
That means the more of the registration of crime, which in my place at least I have been encouraging, because you know, until unless the people come forward to register the crime, the criminal justice system will not start. You know, the first step is that your complaint, your incident has to be reported and it has to be registered.
Absolutely.
So that the investigation starts and you start getting the criminal justice system into action.
Okay.
So my point is, ye to bahut zaruri hai that cases आना चाहिए थाने में अगर स्टैटिस्टिकली अगर बढ़ भी जाए बट इट इज ओके आई मीन एटलीस्ट द
पीपल आर रिपोर्टिंग
सिस्टम यस
पीपल आर रिपोर्टिंग
सो दैट इज व्हाट एंड अलोंग विद दैट देयर इज इंक्रीज ऑफ यू नो पॉपुलेशन सो दैट आल्सो रिसेंटली आई रोट एन आर्टिकल यू नो द रिलेशन बिटवीन क्राइम एंड डेवलपमेंट इन नेशनल न्यूज़पेपर
सर इफ आई कैन इंटरप्टिंग यू सर यू हैव गॉट अ डॉक्टर डिग्री इन क्राइम एंड डेवलपमेंट फ्रॉम आईआईटी गुवाहाटी
Yeah, before last year I completed it, and that's about economics of crime.
Economics.
That is, you know, relating to why people commit crime, you know, what is so economic behavior along with the criminal activities.
The psych behind the crime.
Psych and whether there is any monetary benefits out of it or not. Okay. When a criminal does a crime, what are the different parameters he will think mentally?
Right.
Before committing the crime, the cost benefit, you know, of a particular crime. So it's an interesting. I built up some statistical and mathematical models on that, and analyzed the crime of Assam for last almost 30 years.
30 years you have analyzed the crime, sir. Okay. Very nice, sir. And one thing, sir, like as you were saying, that the domain has increased and the terrains, of course, it's a challenging job, and you find it difficult and you find it interesting also. It inspires you to come up with new method. One thing what you said is very positive, that the number of case registers are going up. That means that perception that people are afraid to go into the police station and register a case
that is,
gradually coming down. That is do you agree with that, sir?
Yes, I do agree, because we have taken special step on that, you know.
Okay,
we have been working. Say, for example, you know, you must be aware there was a particular crime called witchcraft and witch hunting in Assam, in different areas, even in India, elsewhere also. So in 2001, from Assam Police, I started a project called Project Prahari.
Okay.
The Project Prahari was basically aiming at, you know, reaching out to the marginalized groups, very far away places, you know, the women folks who are suffering from witch hunting and all. Now it has become a people's movement. There are a lot of NGOs, a lot of social activists, action groups, students, science clubs, there are women groups, all are coming forward to fight against this crime.
Okay.
So my point is, if the police or the law enforcement agency, they go along with the community members, you know, to prevent crime, I think it's a very good option for us.
Now, if I'm permitted to ask you, sir, you come across as a very, you know, a true gentleman, and the top cop thing is also with you, the super cop accolade is also with you. And you have got the President's Medal also for doing some great work. You were part of the anti-insurgency operations. Sir, how does it, you know, how do you balance the things?
No, it's my, one thing is my job profile. Then another is my personally liking certain activities. In case of job profile, I must say that for last several decades, we have been fighting against insurgency. I was working in some districts where, you know, a lot of districts where you have been having such problems
with
now slowly it came coming down, and all. So it's good that we are making a dent, you know, making an impact on the society in law and order terms. Plus another thing is very important, you see, when you really feel that you are needed by the people at the time of emergency or at the time of need, and if you can offer service, you know, so that gives a very good feeling that, look, we are actually doing something good for
the
people.
Satisfaction. The satisfaction with it. Sir, I'd like to shift the paradigm a little bit and come to your the literature part of you. You were winner of Sahitya Academy Award of 2015 for your novel, that is Akahor Sobi and Ananya Galpa. Sir, would you throw some light on that? I'd like to hear from you.
Well, 2015, I got the Sahitya Academy Award for Akasar Sobi Aro Ananya Galpa. So this was a fiction, actually, collection of short stories. Kahani hai isme. Bara tera ki kuch kahani hai. Acha. Usme, maine, I have shown basically, you know, different types of mental, you know, journey of the different characters. So my writing has been, I have written around 20 short story collections, 20 books I have. Out of these, if you look at my stories, usme zyadatar matlab mansik avastha ke bare mein hi bolte hain, no? It's a mental journey inward, because I feel everybody has a universe of his own. अपना एक ब्राह्मण रहता है मानस, यू नो, मन में. उसी यूनिवर्स में हाउ ए पर्सन गोज अलोंग, यू नो, व्हाट टाइप ऑफ डिफरेंट थॉट प्रोसेस इज कमिंग. सो इट्स बेसिकली एन इनवर्ड जर्नी ऑफ द कैरेक्टर्स, यू नो. दिस इज द बुक अबाउट. एंड रिसेंटली आई गॉट माय इंग्लिश ट्रांसलेशन ऑफ अ पर्टिकुलर बाय द नेम ऑफ इफ ए रिवर. So I'll just tell you quickly, if the story of a river is about how three little kids were playing in the desert, and they have never seen a river. So they heard about it, what a river is. So they wanted to make a river in the desert.
A river in the desert.
So they were trying to make a river, and that story is about that, you know. What type of different roles come to their mind, then the viewers who are seeing it, you know. Those sort of things. So this is basically, you can say, like, you know, going into the right. characters mindset, into the character. You know, that's what.
And you have written a lot of for theaters also, scripts also, sir.
Dramatics is a very important field for me. I have around 4 or 5 dramas. And in fact, my full-length play was translated to Hindi and it was staged in Sri Ram Center for Art and Culture in Delhi.
Sir, kya naam hai unka thoda batao?
Govardhan Das tha.
Govardhan Das ka naam, theek hai.
तो हम जब दिल्ली स्कूल ऑफ इकोनॉमिक्स में थे तो उसके बाद आई वाज वर्किंग एज अ प्रोफेसर इन हिंदू कॉलेज इन इकोनॉमिक्स तो उसी टाइम में हम लोग का एक ड्रामा ग्रुप थे मतलब तो उसी ग्रुप के अंदर हम लोग ये ड्रामा स्टेज किए थे गोवर्धन दास बोल के वो बाद में असम में कई बार असमिया में किया भी है तो इट्स गुड लाइक दैट आई हैव मेड टू टेलीविजन फिल्म्स इन दूरदर्शन इन अर्ली 90s तो वो भी मतलब सोशल थीम के ऊपर
ही था आई हैव टू आस्क यू व्हिच इज एन अर्बन प्रॉब्लम बेसिकली इज अबाउट द ट्रैफिक प्रॉब्लम इट इज अ पेरिनियल प्रॉब्लम What do you think can be the solution, sir, of this dreaded
Look, you see, your infrastructural facilities like, you know, right. the road communication, mm-hmm. all sorts of things, signaling system, right. all have to increase in to right. cope up with right. the developmental scenario Absolutely. And the population. Right. So that has to come up.
Right.
So I feel that lot many times we should go for, you know, technical assistance, you know, rather than putting more policemen on the street.
Right.
So that will help. In future, I think we have to think about mass transit system where a lot of people can travel rather than everybody using the, you know, individual vehicle so that it will lead to, you know, it is leading to a lot of pollution also, air pollution. So best way would be probably the mass public movement transit system where a lot of people can travel together.
Absolutely.
Such type of things one has to think of.
Means a lot of planning has to go in.
A lot of planning, yes. It's generally a developing arena, you know, how traffic goes up and how, you know, the system takes care of it. So that is how we have to be doing it.
Mm-hmm. Okay, sir. It has been, sir. Anything you are doing right now on the literary front? You were writing something or
not really? After I joined this post, it's becoming too much of a responsibility and it's taking away the time. But still, you know, I have it in my mind. You know what we'll do in future.
Something will definitely come in the near future.
Sometime one or two short stories I have written after joining this post.
Okay.
So that has come in the paper and all. So let's see how it goes.
Yes. I will ask you some questions. Mm-hmm. Basically, to know you more, first of all, I would like to know from you, sir, aap kaun sa cheez zyada pasand karte hain? Film, dramas, theaters, aapka pasandita cheez kya hai?
Dekhiye, main drama zyada pasand karta hoon because live hota rehta na, saamne ekdam pura real characters kaam karte hain. Aur hum drama mein the to basically
to ek live ek jo hota hai usme it's like
but film also I mean almost good. I mean I have seen lot of classical prize winning films of the world and all. So acha hai humko, acha
acha. What's your favorite film that you have seen?
फेवरेट फिल्म तो अभी याद कैसे करूं बट वन थिंग एक आक्रोश बोल के था
आक्रोश गबन निहलानी
जी का और दैट हैड मेड लॉट ऑफ इंपैक्ट ऑन अस यंग दैट टाइम वी आर यंग स्टूडेंट्स एंड ऑल
दैट इज अ पाथ ब्रेकिंग फिल्म
वेरी वेरी गुड देन इंग्लिश वाज बाइसाइकिल थीफ
आपका फेवरेट एक्टर कोई है सर
एक्टर तो आई वाज लुकिंग एट यू नो अर्लियर Nasiruddin Shah was enjoying his film then, you know, such type of things.
Assam is icon, if I ask you, who will be that, sir?
See, icon is very difficult to point at because different types of people I have for different domains,
absolutely,
you know.
Absolutely.
Say, in literary world, mm-hmm. I like Saurabh Chaliha. He had given a treatment of Assamese literature, nobody had done it.
Yes.
So I like his. Then in English literature, I like Aldous Huxley's book, you know.
Okay.
And this is what is important, but maybe in different fields, I will have different people.
And from the singing fraternity, anybody you'd like to mention?
Look, if you ask about Asmi's, singer, yeah. Nobody can beat Bhupen Hazarika, right?
Yes, so.
And in Hindi, generally I keep changing, whatever new song comes, it comes to me. Of course, Mohammed Rafi, Kishore Kumar and those people.
The golden oldies are of course there, but according to the changing times also.
That is true.
Somebody has fascination for good foods. Mm-hmm. You have such like that, do you think, sir?
Food, I'm not a very good eater, traditional food
traditional.
I like, but of late I started finding how, the cookery is like, sort of cooking has become sort of a little, I'm trying to build up a new hobby in cooking, because I feel it's also a science sort of a thing, it's a lot of art, lot of science in it.
Absolutely, sir.
So I, developed a new liking for it, not more than eating, I started doing
developing a new hobby of cooking. That's so nice to know that, sir. So, it's, for me, it has been enlightening talking to you, sir. And hopefully the viewers will also.
In fact, during my stay in USA, as a Fulbright scholar in the Pennsylvania State University, there we used to have very good drama sort of a thing. Used to have a drama festival in the university. So once they called me to inaugurate one such, drama thing. Mm-hmm. So such things, they keep you going in life, And I feel when you get to know that people are appreciating you, people love you, people feel good for you, that also acts as good, booster for your health and mind.
It gives confidence.
Yes, I feel that the people of this state has been behind me. They have been always supporting me.
Absolutely.
So I think it's a good moral booster, and I'm going along because of them, their love and.
But one thing I'm just tempted to ask you, sir. Your background is economics. Mm-hmm. You had such good academic background. You studied in Delhi University, and then you got taught also in the Delhi University. And sir, you could have become an economist also, and probably the nation would have got a very notable economist. But why did you choose the police service, sir?
Police is a job, right? And
Absolutely.
Economics can go along with your, with your way of doing it.
Right.
In fact, there is no reason why I should do PhD in economics, but I did it. Now I have written a lot of articles, a lot of essays connected with economics, because economics is the moves the society.
Right.
So it's whether you are an economist or not.
Okay.
It's everybody, because economics is a rational behavior.
Rational behavior.
It's like that.
As I sit in this room, basically, I see so many of certificates and accolades from various universities in India and abroad.
What happens is, actually, I have been teaching in a lot of institutes as a guest speaker.
Right, sir.
Like I am Ahmedabad Goad, and I am Rotak, Lucknow.
Okay.
Then Indian School of Business, Hyderabad, then Singapore universities.
Okay.
So that is why you have seen all these things.
Right, what's the thing about Pennsylvania University?
Pennsylvania State University, I was there as a Fulbright scholar for a year, 2000 to 2001.
Right.
And after that, I was working as a consultant in World Bank in Washington for a few months.
Okay.
So this is about that, But otherwise, good. I can keep up with education as such, where I meet people and learn myself.
Right.
In fact, I've been involved in some, there's a school, chain of school in Assam, you must be knowing about it, Assam Jatiya Vidyalaya.
Assam
Jatiya
Vidyalaya.
So when we started this school in early 90s, so that school has reached around now 700 plus schools all over the state.
Over the state.
This is one. Then I'm connected with two or three more such academic institutes.
Okay, sir. Mm-hmm. So we're also into academics also in some way.
I like it that way, because the whole thing is, capacity building has to be done,
Absolutely.
And the students of today's world, the new generation people, they are so aware of things. They have a lot of knowledge.
All
if I am in touch with them, I can learn myself. I can develop.
Yes.
Otherwise, I'll get stuck. My life will get stuck at a particular level.
Of course,
meeting the new generation people, I feel I can learn so many things from them.
New horizons open up.
Yes, everything.
Right, sir. Mm-hmm. Viewers, I feel it must have been extremely enlightening for you to come across such a personality as DGP of Assam, Sri Kuladhar Saikia. For me, it was an absolute pleasure. So, viewers, till we meet again in DD Northeast, do take care of yourself. Thank you.